Welcome back. We're adding some fish to our summer menu, but in a way you've probably never done before.
So let's find out. Martin O'Donnell from the 12 Hotel in Galway is in charge of the kitchen, and as ever, you come with amazing ingredients, and you're going to do something in a unique way. Good to see you, Martin.
Thanks.
Hi, Martin.
Thanks for having me, guys. Welcome back, Laura. It's great
to
be back.
Thank you. Lovely to see you again after so long. How's everything?
It's been great. Yeah, it's been good. So this morning, cooking a really simple dish, 2 pans, but it's a little bit different. So we're doing egg fried rice with a little bit of our own hot sauce from the hotel, and then we're going to top with some monkfish and tiger prawns and chorizo.
Okay.
Oh, so it's quite simple. It's
flavours in there.
It's a lovely dish if you had some rice left over from last night that you can just crack a few eggs, get a dish going. So to get started, we're going to get the monkfish in the pan first, because it's going to take that couple of minutes. So I've cut these into little scallops, so they're like little nuggets of fish.
Lovely.
The thinner they are, the better they are.
Okay.
So we put 3 or 4 of them in, and we're going to put the tiger prawns in at the same time also. So that's one pan sorted. Nice and simple. We're going to pop over to our second pan. Mm-hmm. We're going to let that go there nicely. Little bit of oil as well in. Nice hot heat. And we're going to start with the eggs first.
Nice.
So I find, if you crack an egg on a flat surface rather than on the side of a pot, you get less shell into the egg.
Do the side of the pot. I'm always
and then you're fishing.
And then you're fishing for your shell out. So
the only way I've discovered you get shell out is actually with the remainder of the shell.
So
you know you'd be going at it with a fork, chasing it around the pool.
Yeah,
try it with the remainder of the shell. Anyhow.
So nice and simple. A little bit of butter in.
Okay.
We're going to fry off our onion. So this is just giving, essentially, our scrambled eggs a little start. So it's a little bit of onion,
okay.
Right? So we have our butter, we have our onion.
That's a high heat there, I guess.
It's quite high, yeah. So we're just going to sauté our onion, nice and quickly, very simple. We're going to scramble our eggs. So we're just going to give them a little whisk, nice and simple.
And fish are fine there, just
fish tipping away, lovely. And the key thing with fish, Laura, is not to be prodding it and poking it and move it. What you want to do is get that little crust on the fish. So it's just, we can leave it there, let it do its thing. Little bit of pepper, little bit of salt into our scrambled egg. And here I have some cold rice that we'll say we cooked yesterday.
Okay.
So I'm just going to turn up the heat that little bit faster.
Is
it play ball? It does. Yeah, so we're just getting that scrambled egg in. So very simple, any kind of cold rice cooked, it is cooked. So that's the first thing,
yeah.
So we're just going to get that in there. So enough for 2 or 3 people there. And we give it a quick break it up the egg. Now, if you don't like egg, you don't have to add it in. You can just have it like a nice sauteed rice.
So it does add extra flavor though.
Now we're just going to come back to our fish. We're going to give that a tiny little bit of salt and pepper also. And now we're going to get the chorizo in. So that's chorizo, so it's a nice two-pot wonder.
You just cubed it. And is that cooking chorizo, spicy chorizo, Spanish chorizo? I never know which one to buy.
Whichever you like. It's very simple. If you don't like spice, you don't have to add the spicy one. You can just use a nice cooking one, or you can use a Spanish one. This one for us is a little bit spicy. I do like a little bit of spice.
So, and that's before the hot sauce comes our way.
Exactly. Okay. So the hot sauce, what a treat.
Have you cooked monkfish before?
Oh, I have, yeah.
Have you? I've never done that before.
But usually as a fillet,
okay.
As such. Yeah.
So these are cut into little goujons. Fishmonger can do it. You can have them prepared. You could use any fish whatsoever. So that's the... So with our hot sauce, asked a couple of years ago to produce a leftover recipe. There was a tin of jalapeno juice. Myself and one of the chefs were like, what are we going to do? So it came to be, maybe we'll make our own hot sauce because we were developing wings. So we concepted this hot sauce using tasty ingredients, something that we like. And the chef that made it, Mike, he was like, oh, it's fair nice. So it came the fair nice hot sauce. We use it on our wings in the hotel in the Pins Gastropub, and now we can't stop selling it. So
and you've created that. That's
we've created this one all because some recipe asked me to do a leftover dish, and that's the start of the dish.
And if it had a heat rating on the side of it, how many jalapenos would there be?
Question.
For me, it's quite balanced. It's not like a Tabasco that's like...
Or chilies, actually, I should say,
For me, it's got a lovely, subtle... smooth flavor, and there's heat at the end. So with our rice, so our egg fried rice is essentially ready. Do we want it quite spicy? So I'm going to put in 2 tablespoons.
Okay,
we've no choice.
We're getting spicy.
So as you can see, that's there. If you want it.
So you just got the fumes spicy. Of that. Stripping
so
your nose hair.
If you wanted that little bit extra, you'll get used to it. Depends on which one
you'll
you
find
bought,
it.
Right? So we're just
going
to add a few little more flavors. Some frozen peas.
With colour as well, gorgeous.
Of course. You want to try and get the kids that are interested into it.
Yeah.
And we have some spring onion that will fly through this one. And a little bit of coriander. And that gives the egg fried rice a lovely kind of balance. And it's very simple. It's just a few ingredients.
And that's your base ingredient, the rice that will go with anything.
Exactly. Yeah. Chicken, fish, prawns, salmon, whatever it is. And that's it. It's a two-pot wonder. Mm-hmm. So here we have our fish.
You can feed. How do we know when the monkfish is cooked? Because obviously the prawns change colour, but I haven't cooked monkfish before.
So the monkfish, once it's cut, that little bit kind of thickness. So it's kind of about as thick as, I don't know if we can see that, but it's about as thick as the prawn. So they're about similar size.
Okay.
So once you get a little bit of colour on each side, a minute each side, and they're quite firm to touch. Mm-hmm. So like the prawns, so they're lovely and firm.
Yeah, it's a meaty fish, isn't it?
Yeah. So now we're just going to plate up. So we have that lovely rice. Again, you could put some cherry tomatoes in here, you could put some peppers, you could put some fresh chilli if you wanted a little bit more.
Yeah. Now, I know you're an expert at what you're doing, but this is so quick, you've cooked this. It's like a pit stop cooking. Formula One pit stop cooking.
Ready, steady cook.
Yeah, it really is.
But that's what it's about, I think, because people don't want to be standing up at home. This was actually one of our staples during lockdown in the staff, an egg fried rice with a little bit of hot sauce. Our manager loves a little bit of heat.
Mm-hmm.
We're trying to create different things for him and his wife, Manon. I must say happy birthday to her yesterday.
Happy birthday.
So this was kind of like a little dish that we created for them in the kitchen, and for us, it was quick, so we were like, oh, perfect. Here's your dinner.
And do you put more hot sauce over that then? Are you cooking, I suppose?
Again, Laura, it's up to you. You could. For me, I would.
Yeah, I would too.
These are some lovely local microgreens that give, like, it could be a lovely brunch dish. You could put a little poached egg on top, a little fried egg on top. And you know, my favourite.
Now,
we're not coming
favorite.
Without seaweed.
Here's the Martin O'Donnell touch.
So
here's the signature
this one
touch.
Is a little bit of nori that I picked yesterday morning.
So you've been foraging over the last while.
Definitely, yeah. We've got out again. The restaurants are open. The hotel is open. So,
super news. It must be lovely being back.
Brilliant. It's absolutely delightful. And again, to see our guests back in the hotel as well. So,
indeed. Well, continued success. That looks remarkable. We will perhaps taste during the break with a fire extinguisher on standby. Martin, great to see you.
How special that looks.
Wonderful stuff. All the recipe details, of course, are up on our website. And as always, you can call into Martin at the 12 Hotel and try all the good stuff for yourself.
Thanks, Martin.